National Security Minister Victor Le Corbiniere has acknowledged a connection between unemployment and crime, given the more than 1 percentage point increase in unemployment at the end of the third quarter of the 2013 fiscal year. In 2012, shortly after the Labour Party, which built its campaign around job creation, assumed office, the figure stood at 21.8%. However, the minister says unemployment must not be used as an excuse to commit crime, and he says St. Lucians must move away from the traditional mindset that the onus is on the government to provide jobs for every citizen. He noted that many university graduates return to St. Lucia expecting to be employed in the public service. Mr. Le Corbiniere noted that many of the leading business persons in St. Lucia started off as speculators with very little capital. As far as he's concerned, it's a matter of being ambitious and independent.
What we're seeing has not been largely due to unemployment. It has really been largely due to criminal elements, sometimes very seasoned criminal elements, who are operating particularly in and around the city. One additional area of concern, of course, has been the whole tourism sector and what we need to keep a tab on any problem that arises there. And fairly recently, again, I've been having that discussion with the Commissioner of Police, and I think there's a full understanding that we cannot drop the ball on any particular side of the equation, that we have to keep the ball in check in relation to all that is happening in the country. We cannot say tomorrow, okay, let us focus now on tourism, or the day after, let us focus on what's happening in Castries. We have to keep that all of these areas of concern in the forefront.
Mr. Le Corbiniere says government is awaiting the report from the Jamaica Constabulary Team mandated to investigate the allegations of the 2012 U.S. report, which cited extrajudicial police killings as one of the biggest breaches of human rights in St. Lucia. The team left the island last Friday and will be compiling data to put together a final report. In the meantime, Mr. Le Corbiniere says officers have been engaging in human rights training exercises, but he's worried about the length of time it will take to have this matter involving the suspension of U.S. services to the Royal St. Lucia Police Force resolved. Since this development, members of the police hierarchy have been denied entry into the United States to participate in training programs.
I rather suspect that before we have the report of that investigation, the suspension will continue, because obviously the report of the investigation is going to be a critical instrument in deciding how we go on this issue.
Mr. Le Corbiniere is hoping that the matter involving the suspension of U.S. support to the Royal St. Lucia Police Force can be resolved as soon as possible. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas reporting.